Johnson.
I don't know any Harvey Johnson.
Think harder.
I don't know him. Maybe he's at another hotel.
You got a register, don't you?
I got a register.
Give it to me, boy. Oh, you're gonna make yourself a mess of trouble. $310.
I guess he'd come when I was out, officer.
Now, let me see you go for the phone.
This hotel got no phones.
He thought we was cops.
Who is it?
Mr. Kelly.
What can I do for you?
My friend wants to see your jewelry.
I'm sorry, Mr. Kelly, but I don't keep it here.
You got it in the bank vault.
That's it, Mr. Kelly. I got it in the vault. Could
Harvey,
you come back tomorrow?
Harvey, do I have to look for it?
What do you want to see it for?
God damn, you're dumb. The man wants to buy it.
Oh, why didn't you say to buy it? Here. What's this?
This isn't what you showed me before. I'm serious. You get the rest of that stuff.
Are you interested in everything?
Get it.
And we're going to give you a real good deal.
Well, I was thinking about not selling it just yet.
We're going to give you $10,000.
I got to show them some other people, Mr. Kelly.
I'm giving you $10,000 today, right now.
That's over $100,000 worth of diamonds retail. Hot, the line is $50,000.
$10,000.
Thank you, Mr. Kelly, but I don't think I want to sell them.
Nigger, you already sold them.
No, that ain't right. I ain't going to sell them for that money.
Touch those rocks, and you're dead. Pick him up. Let's get out of here.
Make it 15, please, Mr. Kelly. You're robbing me.
How'd you get him?
That ain't right. It just ain't right. $100,000 worth of diamonds going for a measly
God
10.
Damn it. Quit complaining. Now, as hot as you are, I could have walked in here and taken them off you. But I didn't. There's no reason why colored and white can't treat each other fair.
Thank you.
some kind of con together.
You better believe it. Oh, folks, you did everything right. I mean, you're really getting your con together. How do you feel?
Like a guy that's just laid the most beautiful broad in the world.
Man, you were evil. You know that? If you touch those rocks, you're dead. You got a mean thing going on inside you.
And you old bastard, you cried real tears.
Yes, I did. Real tears.
How'd you do that?
I knew that if he didn't give us $10,000 for those rocks, we'd be out the 50 bucks we paid for them. It made me cry.
God damn, what a sucker. I almost feel sorry for him.
Don't waste your sympathy on Marks. Those sons of bitches are thieves at heart. They'd play the con themselves if they knew how.
Tell you this, but I ain't gonna play the con no more. I'm gonna lead a different kind of life, simple, close to the earth. As far as a man can see, green fields rolling out to the horizon.
Don't do it, folks. In your heart, you're a city boy.
Okay, I'll spend it all on hookers. See it.
See what?
The money.
Oh, the money. Slipped my mind. Here. Count it yourself.
Damn. Look at it.
Don't let that go to your head, son. There's still room for improvement. Hey, baby, where you been with your bad self?
Waiting for you.
Want a drink, Cleo?
Why, yes. I believe I'd care for a cocktail.
What kind of a cocktail?
A grenadine cocktail.
What the hell's that?
That red stuff. You mix it with soda. It's delicious. It's a ladies' drink. Why'd you give him all that money?
What money?
I saw you give him money.
It's his share, sugar. Now, we made ourselves a hefty piece of change today. You're gonna have more than one Christmas this year.
Well, what did he do for his share?
I tell beautiful lies for my money, Cleo.
Folks pays his way and then some, baby.
Are you insinuating that I don't?
You pay your way too, sugar. But for me, for a hustler like me, folks is a gift from heaven. I knew it the minute I saw him and found out he was really black. His white skin gives us a slick edge. I catch the black marks, he catches the honkies. I say, let's get that goddamn Peckerwood's money. He says, let's break that nigga's back. We got him squeezed in. Between us is a perfect setup for a con.
I still don't believe he's a nigga.
I knew his mother, Cleo. Now, she's the same color as you.
I ain't never heard of no white trick baby so square he tried to pass for black.
Cleo, for the last time, he is black. Hey, folks, we're going to Silks and party back. The three of us.
Well, why does he have to come along? Why can't me and you ever have any fun alone?
We're gonna have that kind of fun right now, baby. Now, come on, don't be so hard on folks. Give him some slack. After all, he was living here long before you came. But that don't matter. You still the star boarder.
I got to go get dressed.
Short conversation.
She gets moody.
Cleo, what's the matter?
You called me a boarder.
That was a joke.
Well, I'm not a boarder. I'm your wife, and this is my home. It ain't right you call me a boarder.
I was just teasing.
Well, I don't like being teased when there's other people around, especially him.
Okay. I won't talk to you that way anymore. In front of the border.
Just because I laughed don't mean I'm not mad at you.
Give me a kiss.
I ain't kissing nothing.
Come on. That ain't no kiss.
How much you get?
Everything's gonna be all right, Uncle Liz. Everything's gonna be all right. Hello, Father, this way.
I want to see him.
In a couple of minutes, Aunt Rosa, in a couple of minutes. How is he?
Not very good.
You treat him like you treat me. Don't spare anything. Don't make any mistakes, huh? I love that old man.
Eno. There's a cop outside. I think he's got something you should hear.
Dot. Eno, this is Dot Murray's with the 23rd Precinct. Dot, this is Mr. Pirelli.
Did Vincent tell you why I come?
No.
I don't know what this has to do with your uncle's heart attack, but I hear he was swindled pretty bad this afternoon. You know Greenblatt.
He's a fence.
That's the one. And with all respect to your uncle, I think he tried to buy some hot diamonds.
From this Greenblatt?
No. He tried to sell them to Greenblatt.
My uncle don't deal in jewelry.
That's how he got took. The diamonds he bought was only glass. They wasn't worth nothing. Greenblatt said that your uncle told him that he paid 10,000 cash. He said your uncle looked real upset when he walked out.
You know who sold them the phony rocks?
Well, I don't know, Mr. Pirelli, but I think they were colored.
Find them for me.
Well, it's not going to be easy, but I'll do whatever I can.
I want those sons of bitches. You find them for me.
Cab in this neighborhood. Don't worry, I'll get you one. Today I'm working miracle.
Why didn't he stop?
What you doing in this neighborhood?
There's a woman here. She does clothes for me.
Man, what the hell is the matter with you?
The lady needs a cab. Come on. Maybe I better go with you. I'm from Chicago.
Oh, are you here on business?
I'm staying at the Parkview. I got the biggest suite in the hotel. The Parkview. I just made the biggest business deal of my life. I'm riding high, and I've got to celebrate. I don't know anybody in town. My name's Johnny O'Brien. What's yours?
Susan.
Hold these. I'll be right back. Hey.
Yes, sir?
I want the biggest suite in this hotel.
Do you have a reservation, Mr.?
No, I don't have a reservation.
Oh, yes. Well, I'm terribly sorry, but I'm afraid we don't have any space available. If you'd try the hotel...
Like I said, I want the biggest suite in this hotel. Bottle of champagne. Yeah. The best you got.
I asked you where we're going.
Shh. That's what I call service. Look at that.
No, thank you. I really have to go meet my friends.
Don't move. Don't break that flow. Can't you feel it? That's the good flow. It's working for me, and it's working for you, too. Hey, don't break it.
I have to go. I appreciate what you did for me this afternoon.
Oh, what I do for you. I called you a cab.
I was scared.
Of what?
All those black faces. I know it's foolish, but I was scared.
Don't be scared, goddess. Look, a champagne cork, a match.
You're crazy.
That's all it takes to make a black face. How about this blackface, goddess? You scared of it?
Hey, watch out. You get that stuff all over me. You get my sweater dirty.
That's right. You better take it off.
No.
Okay, I'll do it.
No.
Here. Drink your champagne.
Look, you have got me dirty. Johnny, I have to leave now. My friends are waiting. I'll see if I can clean this.
Yes, darling. Yes, little darling.
John, let me wipe your face first.
Hold on. Yeah, baby. Yeah, stay with me, love. Stay with me, love.
Come to me. Come to me, Johnny. Hold me, Johnny. Talk to me.
Stay with me. Like it. Am I good? Am I good? Baby.
Let me run it down to you. Now, in this world, there are only two kinds of dudes. That's hustlers and suckers. And tonight, I'm drinking to the suckers. God bless their greedy little hearts. Because without them, where would us hustlers be?
Right on.
Now, look here, sister. I want you to bring me a champagne set up over there and take care of the rest of the house on me.
Hello.
Hello, little baby girl.
Hey, baby, what did you do? Rip off the mint?
You better believe it. I ripped off all them gold bars. And if they make me mad, I'm going back for the silver one.
Hey, folks, come on over here.
Where'd you go?
We're about to have a feast. Come on, sit down. Have something to drink.
Yes, Dave. I got something going.
What you got going that's more important than something to eat and something to drink, huh?
You need any help?
He don't need no help.
Look, he's a child. He don't know how to do nothing unless I tell him how. Hey, folks, when that old man walk... Hey, come on, sit down. Move over, baby. Folks, when that old man walked out of that room today, I was in heaven. If I'd have died that minute, I would have had a smile on my face.
When he walked east and I walked west, Jim, I could have spread my wings and flown over to Disabled Hotel.
You know something, with your complexion and my brains, the sky's the limit from now on.
That's square business, the stone truth.
Go powder your nose, sugar.
I don't need to.
You need to.
Hello, Felix.
Hello. I believe you got something for me.
What do you mean, Felix?
Fooling around with that young pussy affecting your mind, Blue. Surely you haven't forgotten our agreement. Let me refresh your memory. I get 20% of all the clean scores in Philly. I get 25% outside. I take half of all the dirty ones when you get an indictment. Judges cost money. You stay out of Upper Darby and Levittown because the goddamn judges and police chiefs up there are square johns, and 10 grand won't fix a parking ticket. Guaranteed to keep you out the joint as long as I'm doing the fixing, but when you make a score and I don't get my end, I'll hear about it. I won't tip you, I'm wise, but when you come up on a solid beef, I'll whisper in the judge's ear and the Supreme Court can't keep you out of penitentiary. You kill a nigga, it's 5 grand. If you kill a white man, don't come round. Now, give me something to remember you by. Got to wish you luck.
It's you liberals who have lifted them up, Howard.
Paul, you conservatives make a mistake. You can't afford to strangle hope in people.
They realize he sold them out and they grow to hate him. He becomes worthless to them and safe for us.
No, thank you. In fact, in his love for the creature comforts, except for his color, he's become one of us. Paul, Mr. O'Brien has just been telling me a very interesting story. Go ahead, Mr. O'Brien. How are you going to make all that money?
I'm making an investment.
Oh,
what kind of an investment?
Property. I'm buying property.
In the ghetto?
Yeah.
That's good business?
It is, if you know what you're doing.
And you know what you're doing.
That's right.
I'm a doctor, Mr. O'Brien, but occasionally I do invest in real estate. I must admit I'd be a little hesitant about making an investment in the black ghetto.
You might be wrong about that.
You really think so?
In a day or two, I'm going to make some very happy niggers by plunking down $100,000 for their ghetto property. Of course, they don't know I've already contracted to sell it for $500,000. I think I'll get a refill.
You think there's anything in it?
Possibly. What kind of property are you buying?
Tenements.
Then can you explain how you managed to make such a good sale?
It's the location. The value of that land's going up. The blacks are too stupid to realize what it's really worth. I'm not. Excuse me.
Mr. O'Brien, I might be interested in seeing that property.
Yes, so would I.
I can't show it to you.
Why not?
Well, why do you think? You might try to cut me out.
I don't do business that way, Mr. O'Brien.
What about you, Gus?
I can't play with these.
You in, Doc?
I'm out. Oh, now, wait a minute. I'm not making any propositions. I don't need any investors. The money's already lined up.
Is it your money?
Part of it. Part of it's local money. I'm going to spread the wealth among some of your fellow citizens.
I'm in.
If he's in, I'm out.
If you out, brother, then I'm in.
Have you already collected your money from your local backers?
No, not yet.
What if they change their minds? Wouldn't it be a good idea to have someone else to turn to?
I suppose so. But they're not going to change their minds. It's too good a deal.
How can you be sure?
Why take a chance? Show us the property. It won't do any harm.
Blue, telephone.
And find out who it is. I ain't moving.
Call and raise 50.
50 more?
You wouldn't dump me, would you, Blue?
Don't try to calm me, Sonny. I'm bullshit proof.
I'm out.
It's Folks Blue. He says it's important.
Hey, what you have, Blue?
Make it fast. The cards are hitting good.
I got something going here that's hotter than your poker game. Listen to this. I got three dudes here that are ready. I'm sorry, I can't do it. I can't take you to see the property.
Why not? Who did you phone?
There's a black real estate agent. He holds the options to the property. I phoned him.
And he said we couldn't come?
He doesn't want you to come.
But what's he got to say about it? You're the one who's bringing the money. He certainly is no position to tell you what to do.
It's the money he's worried about. He's afraid my investors will back out if they find I'm showing the property to someone else.
But how are they going to find out? Who's going to tell them? Your black friend is stupid.
He feels we're obligated to them.
That's nonsense.
This is a question of business.
You gentlemen seem to have found quite a lot to talk about. Did I come at the wrong time?
No, of course not, Susan.
Would you excuse us a minute? Johnny, let's get out of here. My friends seem very dull this evening.
Susan, we were just talking business with Mr. O'Brien. Would you give us another minute?
Of course, Howard, if you insist.
Get your coat. I'll be right with you.
Well?
Will you show us the property?
Don't let that black man tell you your business.
Johnny?
Okay. You people have made me feel at home here tonight, even though you don't know me, and I appreciate it. I'll take you around tomorrow morning, but under these conditions. If you like the deal, you have to be ready to move on the spot before there's any chance the other investors hear anything about it. I'll have $10,000 in cash. You bring $90,000. You bring it in cash, strictly cash on the table. That's for your protection. Nobody finds out that prominent white citizens have been fucking their poor black brothers. And remember, I can't guarantee anything. That black son of a bitch is nervous and scared. I mean, I don't know if I can even get him to talk to you. Don't worry. We'll convince him. They're hooked, man. Absolutely hooked. I mean, the dumb bastard, they talked themselves right into it.
What else could they do? They got larceny in their hearts. Look here. I've been working it over in my head. Now, the first thing we got to do is find ourselves a vacant lot.
Mm-hmm.
That's not necessary, Mr. Murray. Everybody in town knows you're one of our finest Negro policemen. A credit to his race.
Bullshit.
Would you care for a drink?
Tell this half-white trick baby keep his mouth shut, I'm gonna put my foot in his ass.
Look, Mr. Murray, light skin is no indication of illegitimacy. Just because the man has a white father and a black mother
is... Look, nigga, I didn't come here to talk race with you.
Hey, man, if you don't dig the conversation, why don't you just split?
Because I'm more trouble to you gone than I am here talking. I know about Frescati.
Who's that?
That bagel that sells hot clothes.
Oh, yes. I never knew the old gentleman's name, but I know the shop well.
Yes, he's in the hospital. Steven, son of a bitch, had a heart attack.
That's a terrible thing, but what's that got to do with us?
I hear Frescati was sold some hot rocks this afternoon. Tried to pass him off on Greenblatt Defense. Turned out there was only glass. He dropped right on the spot.
You seem to be driving at something, Mr. Murray, but for the life of me, I don't know what it is. Do you folks?
Oh, he's lost me, Blue.
You know, you two hotshots don't know what every whore and hustler in town knows. That old man was Nino Pirelli's uncle.
I beg your pardon.
Interest denied.
What do you want, Murray?
Blue, I thought you'd never ask. I want $5,000.
What for?
Son of a bitch. So I don't go to the phone booth and call Nino and tell him how you did the old man.
Mr. Murray, you're a good detective, but if you heard that we were playing con for Frescati today, I'm afraid your ears lied to your brain.
Hey, look, the only business I ever had with Frescati was shopping for some of them hot furs he sells.
That's fine. I'll tell that to Nino when I call him.
I know a certain white gentleman, very influential, even in the police department. I believe this gentleman could explain the truth to Nino's satisfaction, but of course that might take some time.
Time is what you're paying $5,000 for.
$500.
Pirelli's at the hospital. He's crying like a baby. You're both dead.
Okay, $1,000.
Open your ears, nigga. I said $5,000.
Man, I don't have it.
You're a lying motherfucker, Blue. I mean, it's either $5,000 or your ass. Now you take your pick.
Well, while I'm thinking about it, I'm going to the men's room. My bladder's killing me.
Piss in your pants. First, give me my money.
Man, I wear a money belt. What do you want me to do? Undress on the bar?
You go out the back way. I deliver this trick baby to Pirelli. After I'm finished.
Hey, baby, I need your time.
We know that after we give you this money, you don't go straight to Nino and enjoy a double payday.
Oh, you don't know anything. You just got to take my word for it, because you don't have any other choice.
Listen, you son of a bitch, I don't have to take your word for anything. Before I believe you, I'll walk out of here with this $5,000 and take my chances with Pirelli.
Wait a minute now, man. Be cool. We can straighten this thing out. Look, why don't we give you half the money now? When we're in the clear, we'd mail you the other half.
You must think I'm some kind of fool, think you're going to send me the money after you're gone.
What about this? The three of us put the money in the mail addressed to him. Now, that gives us till tomorrow to get away, and he can't touch the money till the postman brings it.
What do you use for brains, man? Once that money is in the mail, nobody can touch it. Nobody. And he can call Nino anytime he wants, and that money is still coming.
Hell, man, I'm not thinking.
We're wasting time.
Wait, here, I got it. Here's how we do it.
No more ideas.
Wait a minute, man. Listen, this'll work. Now, we mail the money.
Forget it. We mail nothing.
Look.
Sit down. I want to hear this.
Okay. We mail the money, but the difference is we mail it to Murray and carry it to Precinct House. And now, we'll put a note in it saying, this is your end of the Frascati score, and you sign it. And you call your white friend. You tell him if anything should happen to us, he should tell the chief inspector that Mr. Murray is expecting a very incriminating letter. So, you fuck us, it's your ass.
Okay, I'll buy it.
Hey, it's airtight, Blue. You got an envelope?
I think I got some. You got a pen? Give me a pen. What's the address?
6526 55th Street. Hold it, you slick bastard. Spread those envelopes out. There's another one in there with my name and address on it. It'll be the last time you ever pull a switch. Spread them. All right.
Let go. I'm gonna mail it.
I'll mail it.
Do we have to go to the mailbox looking like this?
I'll be damned if I let you con me. We'll put this in the box together.
I'm scared of Dot, and I'm more scared of Pirelli. We ought to forget about this real estate thing and leave town for a couple weeks.
What are you saying, folks? Where you coming from? It's your con. You set it up and you did it perfect. You just can't split before it's finished and forget about it. It's too beautiful. And what about all that money?
Look, that little wad of toilet paper will never make the morning mail. It'll be 3-4 in the afternoon before Dot finds out just how dumb he is.
Meanwhile, we make ourselves $90,000 richer. And here's just a little piece of property that's gonna do it for us.
Mr. Merritt.
Mr. O'Brien.
I'd like you to meet Mr. Phillips, Dr. Carlson, and Dr. Morrison. These folks are very busy men, Mr. Merritt, but they've taken the time to drive all the way across town today to look at your property.
We talked about that last night, Mr. O'Brien. That piece of property is already spoken for. I think you know the situation better than I do.
Now, I'm well aware of that, Mr. Merritt, but these people aren't going to do anything to upset our deal. They just want to take a look.
What's the point of them looking when the property's already spoken for? I don't think we should do it, Mr. O'Brien.
Now, listen to me. I have given up an entire morning for my work to come here, and my time is valuable, both to me and to my patients. I don't like to waste it. We have assured Mr. O'Brien that we will do nothing to upset any prior arrangements you and he may have made. All we're asking is a chance to see the property.
Well, I don't suppose it'll do any harm to drive by.
That's all we want, Mr. Merritt.
All right. Shall we go? But remember, it's already spoken for.
Big difference in your community, Mr. Merritt.
Oh, yes. Gonna be good for everybody.
And do you own this land, is that right?
No, not this. This. See, I don't own it. The people own it. They got together and made me their agent, that's all. This is very valuable property, and I think that the people should make some money from it.
It'll look great once it's all torn down. It'll look even better with a $6 million shopping complex on it. Tomorrow, I hand that simple bastard $100,000. He hands me the deeds to every piece of property on this block. Friday morning, I hand over the deeds to the attorney for the biggest contractor in this state. And he hands me $500,000. Well, thanks for your time, Mr. Merritt.
That's all right, Mr. O'Brien. I'll see you tomorrow with your back.
I guess we'd better get back. I'm sorry I didn't run across you folks before. Let's go.
Now, wait a minute. Isn't there some way we can get in on this?
You haven't signed a contract with those other people, have you?
No.
We have the cash with us right now, just like you said.
Business arrangements sometimes fall through at the last minute. You can't ever be certain about an undocumented promise. Show him the money, Paul.
I've changed my mind, Mr. Merritt. I've decided to go with these investors instead.
But you can't do that.
Why not?
Because we already promised those other people. Because it's not right.
Are you a businessman, Mr. Merritt, or a moralist?
What are you going to tell those people when they show up tomorrow?
That we took a better offer. Show them you're serious. Here's my $10,000. This is the language I understand, Mr. Merritt. This says these people are sincere and ready to do business with you right now.
But we gave our word.
Let me make one point, Mr. Merritt. What happens to the people on that block if the deal falls through tomorrow? What happens to those poor, unfortunate people who have here an opportunity for the first time in their lives?
When you look at it that way, it does seem right.
It's a deal, then?
I just don't know.
We'll raise the price. How about that? Paul? More? All right, put it all down, Paul. Now, that's all there is. That's as high as we'll go.
I really don't feel right about this. But I do have to look out for the interest of those poor black people, first of all.
I accept your offer.
Excuse me, but something seems to be missing.
What?
Well, the actual deeds to the properties. This is merely an option to purchase. It doesn't have the names of the actual title holders.
Well, I'm picking those up tomorrow morning. All the people are meeting then because they're expecting their money to come tomorrow afternoon.
Then you don't actually plan to turn this money over until tomorrow afternoon?
That's right.
Then we'll bring the money tomorrow.
How do we know for sure that you will bring the money tomorrow afternoon?
Are you suggesting that you can't trust us?
Oh, no, sir. It's just that we do know the other money is coming tomorrow.
Maybe you're right, Mr. Merritt.
Now, wait a minute. You misunderstand me. It's Mr. Merritt's welfare I'm concerned about. We'd be putting him in a terrible position if we ask him to hold all that money on his person until tomorrow afternoon. After all, this is a dangerous neighborhood. Pick it up, Paul.
Maybe we could put it in a safe deposit box.
Well, that sounds like a good idea, Howard.
Maybe it is. Who'd sign for the box?
I would. I have to get the money out tomorrow afternoon anyway to give it to the people.
But it's our money. One of us should sign for it.
I think Mr. Merritt's afraid you lack confidence in him.
Mr. O'Brien, I think we should go with our original backers.
All right, damn it. So I do lack confidence in Mr. Merritt. So what? We put the money in a safe deposit box, and we set it up with the bank so that it takes two signatures to open it. Merritt signs for his side, you sign for ours. That way, both sides are protected, and nobody has to trust anybody.
Back before three.
Come on, Brian, just one drink to celebrate.
No. We'll make it tomorrow. We'll celebrate tomorrow, huh? Move it, Duke. It's 2:45. We gotta get back to the bank.
Trick baby? What you doing in there?
Get the hell out of my way, Dot.
I thought you'd left town.
I am leaving town right now, if you just get out of the way.
You know, Trick baby, I've been thinking about that letter. Since you're still in town, I think I'll invite you over to the precinct house. We can wait for it together.
Like hell we will. Don't be stupid, Dot.
Listen to me, you half-white son of a bitch. You think your white blood makes you smarter than me? I can do as I damn please.
Yeah, you try. Try and take me in. I'll have the police commissioner and Nino Ferrelli looking over your shoulder when you slit open that envelope and the money drops out. Now, man, you can explain the $5,000 to the commissioner while Nino's reading that note. Duke, get out of here and go call Felix.
Stay there.
You think I'd still be in town if I pulled something on you, man? I'd be long gone.
If you have laid the con on me, you and your black friend, it'll be the last con you ever lay.
We gotta get out of here.
We ain't going nowhere without that money.
We can't get into that vault until 10 o'clock tomorrow morning.
Now, before then, Dot and Nino Pirelli both are going to be on us like a chill. We won't have a chance.
God damn it, folks, you're talking like a lop-eared Mark. Every hustler in Philly would call us suckers for sure if we throw away $130,000 to the worms. I'll be goddamn if I'm going to walk away from the biggest score of my life. And besides, $10,000 of that money is ours.
Lou, you're not thinking straight. One of the first things you ever taught me is you got to go with the flow. When it's going your way, get on. When it ain't, get off. We gotta get off.
I say when we get off. Look, folks, I picked you up when you were practically a baby on the streets. I took you in like you was my own son. Now, in all that time, have I ever let you down? Well, have I? I'll say when it's time to get off. What do you think?
Maybe.
Maybe? I think we have found us one prize pigeon.
Step aside, and I'll put one right through his head. Because we're going to share that money, just you and me.
Wait a minute.
You got on how to use it? I used to make a living with this. Don't worry, I won't miss.
Yeah, but it ain't right.
What the hell's right got to do with it? I got a gun, ain't I?
I don't know.
You think I ain't man enough to kill him just because he's white? Shit. I took off a lot of white pants.
Where you going?
Well, he's got to see us, right?
Right.
We'll wait right here. Here he comes. What's he want?
I think he wants to see just one of us. Nope. He wants to see you.
Don't worry. I'll walk him back here.
That jive ass Mark wanted to blow your brains out. He's a dishonest motherfucker, all right.
I almost get my head blown off, and you're laughing.
You're holding $500 in your hand. It took you an hour to make it. Now, ain't that worth a little risk?
Blue, in all the times we've laid the con, this is the first time anybody ever pulled a gun on us. The flow has turned against us. You can't feel it, man. I can. Pull over. I want to get out. I mean it. I want to get out.
What you gonna do?
I'm going to Chicago.
If you're gone, how am I gonna open that safe deposit box tomorrow morning?
Man, you'll never get to that box. Look, man, don't be a damn fool. We can still get out of this thing. Let's leave town right now. Just drive away.
Just drive away from $130,000.
Man, what do you want more, the money or to keep on breathing?
I want both.
Well, you can't have both!
No, I ain't gonna go. Anyhow, I can't go without Cleo.
Goodbye, Blue. I don't know what I'm gonna do without you.
You don't need me. I ain't nothing but an old man. I ain't no help to you. Hell, I've been holding you back. Without me, you can move into the white con, the big time. You'll do fine.
God damn it, man, can the bullshit. I'm going back to the apartment, pack a bag, and I'm on my way. You got any sense? You'll follow me and do just the same thing.
Goodbye, folks.
Lou, I'm really leaving. I'm going to Chicago.
Where's Blue?
Well, how should I know? gratia plena dominus tecum, benedicta tu mea ribusa, benedicta scriptus tu Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater di Dio, prega per noi peccatori, adesso e ad ora della morte nostra, cosa sia.
Ave Maria, gratia plena dominus tecum, benedicta tu mea ribusa, benedicta scriptus tu Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater di Dio, prega per noi peccatori, adesso e ad ora della morte nostra, cosa sia.
Ave Maria, gratia plena dominus tecum, benedicta tu mea ribusa, benedicta scriptus tu Iesus.
Well, I found out who they were, Mr. Pirelli. The two colored hustlers that cheated your uncle. One's name is Blue Howard. They call the other one White Folks.
What do they look like and where do we find them?
I'll get him for you, Mr. Pirelli. I'll bring him to you.
All right. You do that. The price is 5 G's apiece. You hear that? I don't trust him. Keep a tail on him. When he finds those bastards, you take care of him.
Listen, man, I gotta find Blue. You seen him?
I can't let you come in here, folks. It's too dangerous.
I gotta find Blue.
Don't worry about Blue. He can take care of himself. If I were you, I'd get into a white neighborhood.
Johnny, have some champagne.
How'd you get in here?
What is it? What's wrong? What happened to you?
Take off my coat. Be careful in my right shoulder.
Johnny, what happened to you? What is this?
It's a gunshot wound. I've been shot.
Who shot you?
God! Damn son of a bitch in black cop shot me.
You're kidding me.
Yeah, sure, I'm kidding you. Get me some of that stuff. Now take off my shirt.
I'm gonna call a doctor.
Forget it.
Why?
I've been shot by a cop. You don't call a doctor when you've been shot by a cop.
Get away from me, you're a dead man.
Look, Felix, I need help. Money's no object.
I only take money when I can do something for it. I can't do anything for you.
just until tomorrow morning, 10 o'clock.
Do me a favor, Blue. Forget you know me. Already forgot I know you.
I couldn't sleep last night. I had dreams that kept waking me up. I kept dreaming you were with me. Johnny, stay here. Stay with me. You'll be safe here. I'll find a doctor for you. I'll bring you whiskey. Lie down, Johnny. Rest. I'll stay with you. I won't let anybody hurt you. I'll take care of you. You belong with me.
No, I don't belong here. My name is Johnny O'Brien, but my friends call me white folks. My enemies call me trick baby. And girl, that's because I was born in a nigger pigsty in the ghetto. And I came out a black woman.
It doesn't make any difference.
It does make a difference. Believe me, it does make a difference.
No.
Oh, for Christ's sake, leave me alone.
Who do you think you are?
I told you who I am.
I'm not used to being treated like this. Johnny, please don't go. I won't do anything to hurt you. I'm gonna start screaming! I just want to be nice to you. I just want you to stay with me.
Good evening, Mr. Mary. You're wasting your time, honey. He's no trick. Don't tell me he ain't no trick.
I'm looking for Blue Howard and that half-hunky friend of his.
What's that to me? Hey, I ain't seen him.
I want you to put them hoes out looking for him.
Yeah, well, they ain't gonna like that.
You a pimp, ain't you? They do what you tell them to do, don't
they? What do you want me to do, man? Let go.
I want them in every joint that's open. They hear anything about them two swindlers, I want them to call you. And I want you to find me and tell me what they've heard. Now, is that too much for you to understand?
Shot me.
How bad you hurt?
I'm all right. It hurts like hell, but I'm all right.
This whole thing is my fault. I should have checked Frascati out. And I shouldn't have gotten you into this crummy life in the first place.
That's right. I hate you for teaching me con. You put a pistol on me and forced me to make the Frascati play.
No, folks. I'm just a stupid, greedy bastard. Old Funky Blue. You seen Cleo?
No.
You know, I'm kind of glad I made those pre-need arrangements at the Metropolitan Funeral Home now.
Because when they shoot me, I want every hustler in Philly to turn green with envy. I want everybody to know that I was laid out in style. I'm gonna lie there in my luxury casket for everybody to see.
Lou, you're full of shit. You think you're gonna die in some alley with your shoes on. You're gonna die buck naked between Cleo's legs.
Let's go. Move it. Maybe that's that.
Mysterious ways, his wonders to perform. It's been 5 years since I've seen you. He sent you to drive Satan's imps away. I'm gonna pray and give thanks to Jesus.
I want you to pray for me, Josephus, but let's go to your place first.
You ain't in trouble again, is you? You ain't done nothing wrong, have you, Blue?
No.
Swear, because as much as I love you, I can't harbor no criminals.
I swear, Josephus.
Because this house ain't just mine, Blue. It belongs to Jesus, too.
What's the matter with your white friend, Blue?
He's had a little bad luck, and he ain't white, he just looks it.
It's a gunshot wound. He's been shot. Who you are in trouble with the police. That's it, ain't it, Blue? You're gonna have to go. I ain't keeping you here. Now get up, Blue. I don't want you to stay here.
Wait a minute, Josephus. It's not what you're thinking. Now, we are in a mess of trouble, and we do need your help, but it's not our fault. Just let me explain.
Blue, you ain't trying to pull one of your cons on me, are you?
I wouldn't do that, Josephus. Josephus, how long has it been since you heard from back home?
It's been many years since I heard from them good time niggas back home. That's the way I want it. What's that got to do with your white friend being shot?
You remember Sporty and Bob Bigelow?
What about them?
They had a terrible tragedy.
What happened?
What are you doing in here?
You hurt yourself?
Where are they? Why aren't you out looking for them?
You look for them.
Hey, we don't even know what they look like. What do they look like?
Sporty and Bob are walking home. They see this car stalled by the side of the road. Inside of the car is this white girl. She's grinding the starter. They decide to help her. Now, Reverend Joe, they had to be two crazy, unlucky niggas. They walk upon a white woman on a lonely road at 2 a.m. in Bibb County, Georgia.
Were they drinking, Blue?
They were high as Georgia pines.
They had to be.
Anyway, they stuck their head through the window. You know both those dudes would run a close second to King Kong in a beauty contest. She took one look at them, jumped out of that car, and she was screaming rape before she hit the ground. And do you know who she was? Mavis Langley. Her daddy's Hiram Langley, the circuit judge. You can believe they sobered up right quick.
What happened?
Well, Jesus must have known that they didn't mean any harm because he showed them a hideout. You remember that shack that Sporty's daddy built?
That was a long time ago. Is that where Jesus took them?
Sporty and Bob hid in that still shack till daybreak. Finally, Sporty decided that their only hope was to hop a freight going north, but Bob would not move. He was paralyzed with fear. So Sporty left him there, whimpering and huddled like an unborn child in that dark shack.
Jesus have mercy.
Reverend Josephus, Sporty made it to that railroad line. And he swung onto a northbound train and rode it all the way to Philly. Now, I've got Bob's ex-girlfriend's phone number. Jessie, you remember Jessie, don't you? She's the girl with the club foot and the hazy mind. Jessie could tell Bob's friends to go out there and move him to safety. I had the phone in my hand, all set to call her when... Reverend Joe, something snatched that phone out of my hand and I heard a strange voice. Blue! You can't trust those poor, frightened black people to get Bob to freedom. Only you can save him. Reverend Joe, I don't know who took the phone out of my hand, and I don't know who talked to me, but please believe me, it really happened.
Blue, you big black fool. Ain't you got enough sense to know that was the Lord God himself? Praise be his holy name. You touched a sinner with your immortal spirit. Hallelujah, Jesus!
Reverend Joe, you made me see the light. Folks and I were on a divine mission when we went down south and brought Bob back to Philadelphia.
You mean he's here, Philadelphia?
And we had it all fixed up to get the both of them to the one place they'd be safe. Paris, France. But no sooner than we were safe at home than that fool Bob slipped out and called his girlfriend Jessie in Macon. Now, she must have talked. Because 2 hours ago, detectives burst into our place. Now, Sporty and Bob got away, but they wounded folks here. And now they're after us. We've got to get out of the country. We got our airplane tickets, but we desperately need a place to stay until 10 o'clock tomorrow morning. What are we going to do, folks?
Blue, I just don't know. I believe the best thing we could do is to place ourselves in the hands of Reverend Josephus and Jesus.
You're right, folks. I love Reverend Josephus, and I trust his judgment.
I'm not gonna let you leave here, Blue. The Lord ain't allow no harm to befall you here. I'm gonna go downstairs and pray for you.
Did you leave anything out?
Parachute jump. Hell, lying takes my mind off my troubles.
I almost believed you myself.
Listen, you black son of a bitch. You answer me when I talk to you.
You got yourself mixed up with your boss.
You don't talk that way to me, not now, not ever.
We're gonna tell Nina you're not cooperating.
Here's a dime for the phone.
reaching this moment, I've stayed my ass down south. I mean, what the hell good did it do me to come up here and try to improve myself? I was scared of being like one of those ignorant niggas that I grew up with. So tonight, I had to kiss the ass of one of them same niggas. For this, I've come full funky circle, folks. All my life, I've been chasing a rainbow. See, the difference is, I know where the pot of gold is now. It's in a safe deposit box in the Provident National Bank. And you and me got the key. You can't expect us to back out now. I'm sorry, folks. I forgot all about you.
Silks.
Get me Doc Harris out of the back room.
Who's this?
This is Blue, damn it. Go get him.
Doc, Blue's on the phone. He wants you.
Tell him I'm here.
Tell him to get his ass on this phone.
He ain't here.
Why are you borrowing my truck, Blue? Ain't you got your own Cadillac?
I'll bring it back in an hour, Josephus.
I'm going to get the doctor.
Forget it.
No! I want you to be in shape to sign for that money.
Blue, forget about that money.
Damn it, folks, it's not the money I'm worried about. I'm going to get it.
Be careful.
Hurt you?
No, I'm all right.
Where you been?
Waiting for you.
I called the house. You weren't home.
You see my home? You see what that goddamn cop did to it? You expect me to stay there? I've been at the pictures all night, all by myself.
Cleo, why don't you try telling me the truth just this once?
The truth. You wouldn't know the truth if it walked up and spit you in the face. You lied for a living. Shit, I bet you the biggest lie in Philadelphia.
You don't know nothing, do you? You don't know nothing about me. Come on.
Let me alone, Blue.
You better wait here, Cleo. Wait.
Hey, Blue. Yes? You Blue Howard?
Oh, good Lord, no, but I am mistaken for him quite often.
Then what's your name?
Montgomery, Blue Montgomery, Reverend Blue Montgomery. Can I be of any help?
You know Blue Howard?
Yes, I do, more than 20 years.
Know where I can find him?
I wouldn't want to get him in any trouble.
There's no trouble. We got a message for him.
Oh, that's all right, then.
Well, I don't know just exactly where he is. He's a busy man. He moves about quite a bit. But I did see him about 40 minutes ago down at Prince's there on South Street. You know, where the black and white people get together. Maybe if you went down there, somebody could tell you where he is, or perhaps...
Get the hell away from him! He's mine!
Is that the other one?
No, his partner's a nigger, too.
Blue! Blue! Hey, oh, Blue. Hey, man, can you hear me?
Not too good, folks. You don't want to mumble. You speak clear like an actor on the stage, so the mark can hear every word of the con. Don't catch no cripple or cross-eyed mark. They're jinxy. Run like hell from the mark that stutters. Quickest way to go to the joint is to play con for them. And for God's sake, don't catch no mark coming home from a funeral all dressed in black. Folks?